We're coming up on the Tinnitus Awareness Week, and I've been asked to give a little talk about tinnitus. And I want to start by telling you that tinnitus is not a disease. It's a symptom, and it's very common. Basically, 80% of our patients with hearing loss will have tinnitus, and in my experience, about 5% of my patients who have normal hearing have tinnitus. So it can be brought on by any number of things, and in many times, we don't necessarily find a cause. But it is important that patients who do complain of tinnitus have an evaluation, which would include an audiogram or hearing test, and they should see an ear, nose, and throat physician to rule out serious underlying conditions. The most common cause of hearing loss is either exposure to loud noise or just the normal aging process. So, of course, prevention is good. We can't prevent aging, that's normal. But we can prevent exposure to too much noise with the proper use of hearing protection, such as earplugs or ear muffs, when exposed to any kind of loud noise, such as power tools or working in a noisy environment. Or certainly, we see a lot of rock concerts these days where people are exposed to a tremendous amount of very loud noise. The patients that I see with tinnitus, 90% or 95% are not bothered by it. They say, yes, I have it. It's very common. I've had it for many years, and I don't even listen to it. But then there's that group of maybe 5% of my patients who are very disturbed by it. They can't sleep. They say it wakes them up. They have difficulty going back to sleep. They have difficulty concentrating. We also did some testing called the Minnesota Multiphasic Personality Inventory and found that those who had severe tinnitus were either depressed or had anxiety disorders or a combination of both. And more recently, with functional MRIs, we have located the area of the brain where tinnitus is generated. And by the way, it is generated in the brain, not in the ear. So, we now know that it's in the brain and it's located near the limbic system, which is the emotional center of the brain. So, anxiety, depression, pain, anything that adversely affects a person can spill over and cause a stimulation of tinnitus. I became very much aware that anxiety and depression were important components. And I had heard that biofeedback can be helpful. In other words, teaching patients to relax, teaching patients to become more aware of how their emotions and their situation can affect their tinnitus. And we did biofeedback studies, found some good results in many patients. So we find that cognitive behavioral testing treatment can work, biofeedback can help, sometimes medications as a mild sedative or maybe an antidepressant. All these things can help that small group of patients who are very severely disturbed by their tinnitus.
Thank you so much, Dr. House. As Dr. House said, tinnitus is a symptom and not a disease, and it is most often associated with hearing loss. One of the leading causes of hearing loss is exposure to loud noise. That's why this Tinnitus Awareness Week, we partnered with Earpiece, a leading brand in the field of hearing protection. If you're at a concert, working with power tools, or any kind of environment in which you're exposed to loud noise, don't forget to wear hearing protection. Check out Earpiece at the link in our description box below. Don't forget to like this video, comment, subscribe to this YouTube channel, and don't forget to leave us a donation so that you can support the future of research, education, and global hearing health efforts here at House for symptoms like tinnitus.